Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel Base Mechanical Engineering. In this video I teach you impact of jet on moving cow plate and the jet strike at the center of a plate. In this video I teach you the diagram of impact of jet by using these animations, then finding out the force, work done and equation of efficiency. Now this is a pipe. At the end of the pipe there is nozzle is installed, and this is the cow plate, and this cow plate is a moving, okay, cow plate is the moving, and we learn the parameters of this cow plate, that is the angle of deflections and a angle theta. So with the horizontal directions the angle of deflections and theta is given, so this is the theta. Theta is the angle at which the jet is leaves from a plate, that is known as the theta, and this part is known as the angle of deflection, and angle of deflection is represented as a phi. So phi is equal to 180 minus theta. This total angle is 180, so 180 minus theta we get the phi. During the solving examples angle of deflection is given. From angle of deflection we find out the theta. Okay. Now the water jet is coming out with the velocity V from a nozzle. This water jet it strike to the plate, and the plate is start to move with the velocity U, and it's read to the new positions. The velocity of the jet is V and the velocity of the blade is U. Then after the striking, the jet is strike at the velocity is known as the relative velocity. Relative velocity means velocity of jet with respect to the velocity of plate, and jet and plate are moving in the same directions. Jet velocity is V, plate velocity is U. When the two object is moving in same direction, then its relative velocity is minus. So here the jet is strike with the relative velocity V minus U. After striking, the water is leaves from a surface of this cow plate from a both the side, like this way, and it's leave and at certain angles, and its angle is theta as we learn already. So it's exhausted as a certain angle theta, and its quantity is same as the its striking, that is a V minus U, because we considering that the surface of the plate is too smooth, and when the surface is smooth there is a no friction losses, and the jet is leaves at the same velocity that is strike, and it's leave with the angle theta with the horizontal directions from a both the side. So when any velocity is leave at a certain angles, we are able to solve in a two directions. One is x direction, that is a horizontals, and another is a y directions. So on this triangle we are applying the equation of cos theta and the sine theta. When we applying the equation of cos theta, then we get the adjacent, that is the cos theta is equal to adjacent upon hypotenuse. So this side is the V minus U cos theta, and this part vertical is a V minus U sine theta, because we applying the equation of sine theta. Sine theta is equal to opposite side upon hypotenuse. So we getting the two exhaust velocity, that is particularly in x directions and in a y direction. If you learn something, then subscribe my channels and like my video and share with your friends. Let we see the different parameters. V is the velocity of the jet, U is the velocity of this plate in meter per second, D is the diameter of the jet, from diameter we find the area, rho is the density of a fluid, area is find out pi by 4 d square, m is equal to mass of flow rate of a fluid kg per second, so m is equal to rho a in bracket v minus u, because we are considering the relative velocity in a moving cow plate. Now we are finding the two forces, that is a force in x direction as well as a force in y directions. So force exerted by a jet in a direction of jet fx is equal to For finding out the force in an impact object, we are using the Newton's second law of motion. It's equal to rate of change of momentum in direction of force. Momentum means mass into velocity. So initial momentum minus final momentum divided by time. And this momentum is mass into velocity. So mass is taken common. So mass upon time into velocity of jet before striking and velocity of jet after striking. So we are finding out the force in x direction. So we are considering the velocity of a jet in x directions. So velocity of jet before striking is v minus u. Velocity of jet after striking, that is v minus u cos theta. But we are taking it negative. Why we take the negative value v minus u cos theta? Because it's live at a opposite direction to the striking. During the striking, jet is moving from this left side to right sides, and during the leaving it's move from the right to left side. So that is it means opposite direction. When the directions it change, we take the minus signs. So here mass is equal to rho a v minus u, jet before striking, that is a v minus u, after striking minus v minus u into cos theta. So this minus minus is converted into the plus. Again I revise you why we take the minus, because it's velocity at the outlet is opposite direction to the initial velocity. Here left to right and outlet is right to left. And we take the common from this equation, that is a v minus u. So here rho a in bracket v minus u bracket over square into 1 plus cos theta. It is our final equations for the fx. Next we find out the fy. Fy means force exerted by a jet on a curved plate in a vertical direction. So it is known as Fy. So similarly, we are applying the second law of Newton, that is the mass upon time into velocity of jet before striking minus velocity of jet after striking. Mass is rho a v minus u, velocity of jet before striking in y direction, because we are finding out the force in a y direction. So jet completely strike on the x direction. That is in horizontal direction. Jet is does not strike in vertical direction. So we take the velocity of jet before striking is zero, and velocity of jet after striking means here, that is a v minus u into sine theta. So rho a v minus u in bracket zero minus velocity of jet after striking, that is v minus u sine theta. So our final answer is minus rho a in bracket v minus u bracket over square into sine theta. This is our force in a y direction. Next we find out the work done per second by jet on a plate. So our plate is moving in x directions. So in a equation of the work done, we are taking the force fx. So work done is equal to force in a x directions into distance traveled by the plate. So distance in a direction of force, but in this case we are not knowing the distance, so we take the velocity, and when we multiply the force with velocity, we are getting the power. So here we take, it is not work done, but we are considering it is a rate of work done. So force that is considered as a fx, because the plate is moving in x direction, so we only consider the force in x directions. This equation is rho a in bracket v minus u bracket over square 1 plus cos theta into u. So this is the equation for a work done. Next we find out the out efficiency, that is output upon input. What's the our impact of jet output? It is a work done on a plate. And what is our input? That is kinetic energy coming out from the nozzles. So it is a work done on the plate divided by kinetic energy at the input. We have already available of equation of work done. And what is the equation for kinetic energy at the input? So kinetic energy at input is equal to mv square by 2. So that is a mv square by 2. And what is the equation of m for kinetic energy at the input? So for this m we are consider it is a rho a v. We are not consider rho a v minus u, because kinetic energy coming out from the nozzle. From the nozzle the jet coming with the velocity v. So for this kinetic energy at the input, we are consider the equation is rho a v. So instance of a v m, we write the rho a v. So in this bottom side 2 is going upper side, rho a is cancels and v into v cubes. So these are the our equation of efficiency. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like my video, subscribe my channels, and share with your friends.